Dear ones, I am Archangel Michael. I want to bring to you today a subject of extreme importance in the current situation, the feeling called doubt. Then I ask a question, what is doubt? And I answer, it's the lack of faith, it's the lack of trust, it's the lack of certainty. So as you can see, for you there will always be something missing, which was not so deep for you to believe. But what is the truth about doubt? Doubt has a meaning, it has a function, which is exactly to break that chain of faith, trust, light that you place in something or on some subject. When you doubt yourself, what are you doing? They are stating internally that you don't trust yourself, that you don't trust anything you see, that you don't trust anything you hear, anything you feel, anything your intuition gives you, you trust nothing and doubt everything. Every time you doubt, that castle you were building with so much love crumbles, and you have to start that walk again. I've been talking here for some time now, I didn't start today, I didn't start yesterday, I have been working here for a long time. In which all of you who have been there since the beginning and many who have been here for a short time, say the same thing, my life changed after I heard everything that was here. I am very happy when I hear this from you, because it is the certainty that you have found the way and that you believe, that you have no doubt about what I say and that it is I who am speaking. We beings of light, when we come here through any channel, to pass a message, we leave an energy in this message, so that anyone who hears it, anywhere, at any point in time, feels the same thing as whoever heard it the first time when it was published. What happens is that our messages are often altered to contain the energy of the other side. Then many ask themselves, but wait, if the message is from such a strong being, how can they destroy the energy that is inside? This is a good question. Theoretically, actually, we shouldn't allow our energy to be tainted. But understand this, everything is a machine, it is a machine for forcing thoughts, it is a machine for forcing attitudes, for forcing actions. So this machine is very well crafted, very well orchestrated, manipulated, and everything that falls in there falls into a large cauldron of negative energies. If you imagine a styrofoam ball, you paint this ball yellow. If you let the paint dry, it will turn completely yellow. But if you take this ball that is painted yellow, and throw it into a blue container, what will happen? That blue color will permeate the yellow paint and a totally different color will appear, neither blue nor yellow. So this is how I'm trying to explain it to you. Our energy doesn't end, it's still there, just like the yellow paint is still there on that ball. But it was contaminated by another color, so our energy that was in that message is contaminated by extremely strong energies. No, our energy didn't leave there, and no, our energy is not weak. It's just the world you live in. And then I could say this, if every message we put out, we didn't allow it to be tainted, how would you learn what's bad and what's not? This is exactly what makes you realize where the truth and the lie are. So that supposed message, which was previously a message of light, will become a message that will confuse your mind, because it has been surrounded by a very large layer of negative energy. So when you hear what is there, it will not bring light to your heart. It's as if the message was translated into another language that you don't understand. And then you begin to doubt what is there, because that message did not bring you peace, it brought you fear, it brought you anguish, it brought you bad feelings. And this is how it happens on your internet. That's why I've said so many times, be careful what you hear. Because although messages are said from beings of light, they may be involved in this negative energy, which will not lead you to the true message that is there. But rather a subliminal message, totally different. Why am I saying all this? Because you often doubt what you are hearing, you do not believe that there is a being of light speaking. You confuse the channel with the being of light. And how do you know if it is the channel or the being of light that is speaking? Or you could even say that it is not a non-light being that is speaking. How to know? How can you be sure you are listening to an original message from a being of light? This has already been highly commented here. I have already taught it, Sananda has already taught it. So, when many people start listening, certain messages stop midway, because they realize that there is something that doesn't add up. There is something that is not saying exactly what the being of light said. Today in particular, numerically it is a portal, 5 or 5. So I am inviting you to participate in today's meditation. But before that, I want to tell you a few things. Everything I say here, I repeat anywhere on Earth. My messages are spread across the planet and cannot be unique messages, because each place has a different moment, has a different energy, has a different growth, has a different evolution. So everything I say has my energy, it is permeated. Then many hear what I say and interpret it as they please, interpret it the way they think is right, and worse, they claim that I'm not the one speaking. Because effectively, they do not understand or did not understand the content of what I said. Then I ask a question, did you not understand why that message was tainted by negative energies, which distort the meaning or simply because you doubt what is said? This is a question that I'm not going to answer, it's you. So once again I will say here what I have said countless times, when you hear something supposedly said by ask me for proof that it is I who am speaking, that that message is actually from the light and there's my energy there. Ask me for proof, and I will be happy to show you whether it is true or not. Why don't you do this? Why do you accuse, point fingers, label, judge, that I'm not the one speaking? Why? Is the fear that big? Are you bothering someone? So I would like you to ask yourselves why, and I'll say it again, ask me for proof. Now be true, there's no point asking me for proof, I prove it to you and you keep saying it's not me, just so you don't admit you were wrong. Careful. Look what you will be planting. That's all I have to say. Then I ask another question, who benefits from saying that I'm not the one speaking? Who wins? Why is a doubt being generated there and what does the doubt do? Get you out of the way. So who is serving the non-light? Those who judge, those who point, those who don't ask for proof and simply make everyone doubt. Is that it? Is that it? So I want to ask you once again, anyone who doubts that it's me speaking, ask me for proof, don't be afraid, I won't do anything to anyone, it'll just show that I'm the one there, that's all. Don't, as you like to say, take the tram and interpret it as you please. Seek the truth. Careful. Because fear makes you see things that don't exist. Don't be afraid of anything. Everyone has a path, everyone has a mission. Why doesn't everyone take care of their own mission? Why do you have to keep messing around with someone else's mission? So once again I want to say here, whoever doesn't trust my words, that I'm the one speaking, ask me for proof. I make a challenge here, because I know that I am the one here and that I am the one speaking. Whoever doubts, whoever doesn't believe, ask for proof and I will give it. Now, generating doubt, judging, pointing the finger is serving who? The light? I assure you it is not. So be careful with your actions, my brothers, be careful, because you are planting weeds in your paths, not fresh and aromatic herbs. Whoever sows doubt, reaps more of the same, it is the law of action and reaction. So be careful with your judgments, with your opinions, be careful. No one will harm you, only you yourselves are planting and will reap later. So think carefully before pointing the finger, before judging. Don't take the tram walking. My brothers, from now on, you have to be very careful about what you read and what you hear. Very careful. Because we are in the final stretch, we are in that anything goes phase to get attention, anything goes. So in this ridiculous war, because for me it's a ridiculous war, whoever gets the most attention, people are planting bad things. They are not realizing this, they think they are superior, they think they are better than others. So the only thing I have to say is that they will reap everything they are sowing up front. No, it will not be me or any being of light that will do anything against them, it will be the result of their own choices, as Sananda says. You plant choices and up front, you will reap the results. I don't have to justify myself in anything. But whoever doubts me, Ask me for proof and I will certainly be happy to provide it. Do not be afraid. I will not materialize in front of you and fry you with my energy. Don't be afraid, I will know exactly what to show you, to exactly tell you that it's me. Now be adult enough to admit your mistake, don't continue to parade your lies. Because you will also be planting this and, of course, you will reap it later on. I will do nothing. We do nothing. The results, the consequences are the effect of everything you planted. Only that. So I invite you today, at the usual time, to meditation. It will be a very important meditation at this time, so I can take you to a new timeline. Let's speed things up a little more, believe me. I am Archangel Michael. I'm not here to bring doubt or spread bad thoughts. I'm here for the truth, I'm here for the light, and that will be exactly my answer.